Hey guys, I'm Billy, a sales engineer from GridFree. Today we're going to talk about GridFree's battery option. Here at GridFree, we have two different battery options. You have the gel battery option and the lithium battery option. The gel batteries we offer are a 12 volt, 200 amp hour, deep cycle lead acid battery. That type of lead acid battery is optimized for solar, simple battery, and if you look after it, it'll look after you. We recommend the gel battery option if you're running a smaller system, you're not going to be running it full time, or you've got a more constrained budget. This is the standard battery in our kits, and it's more affordable than the lithium option. The lithium option, on the other hand, is a more advanced piece of kit. What we sell are the ARK Growatt lithium batteries. These batteries are 2.56 kilowatt hours of capacity, and they run at 48 volts. This is an upgrade from the standard system. They're longer lived, they're more easily expanded, and they're a lot more than just the battery cells. We recommend these for larger systems, or systems you're going to be living on full time. The cells inside the lithium unit are lithium iron phosphate. They're cobalt free and one of the safest lithium technologies out there. It's all protected by a BMS, or you could call it a battery management system. Our lithium batteries are specifically designed to interface with our Growatt hybrid inverters. What this means is the inverter is going to charge it up correctly and ensure the banks are balanced. All of this is housed in a robust enclosure designed specifically for modularity and easy expansion. Now, let's answer some frequently asked questions. First up, what sort of lifespan can I expect from these batteries? With the correct maintenance, your gel batteries will last about 3 to 5 years, and your lithium about 10. You will still have capacity remaining after this period, it's just going to be greatly diminished compared to when you have them as new. So how are these batteries configured with our kits? Well, the gel battery is a standard option, and this is configured in 24 volt or 48 volt banks. These banks are then paralleled to give you more capacity. As for our lithium option, these are a 48 volt battery, so they're only available in our 48 volt systems. The batteries themselves are in parallel, and they can stack up to 10 high on top of a battery base. If you need more than one stack for more capacity or a larger current output, you can use a battery hub to have up to 8 stacks. So how do I best maintain my batteries? Well, there's a few considerations around this, so we're going to put that in a separate video. Today, we're going to cover the most important parts. So the first consideration is to make sure you keep your battery charge level within the recommended depth of discharge. Depth of discharge, or DOD, is the percentage you've used of your total capacity. For the gel batteries, the maximum DOD is 50%, whereas for the lithium, this is 80%. Going lower than the recommended depth of discharge can reduce the lifespan of your batteries, especially with repeated use. This is more of a concern with the gel batteries rather than the lithium, which is a bit more resistant to that. Another consideration specific to the gel batteries is to make sure you don't leave it at a partial state of charge. Doing this can damage your batteries, so the best counter to this is simply charging up your batteries to full once a day. As for our lithium batteries, they're much more resilient to being at a partial state of charge. So are lithium batteries safe? Well, our lithium iron phosphate batteries, it's one of the safest chemistries on the market. It's even safer than the battery in your phone. So how much space do these battery systems require? Generally, the lithium battery takes up a lot less space. One, you need half as many batteries. They're half the weight, 30 as opposed to 60. And this is modular. It all stacks up in one place. So there's going to be less floor space. So now that we've had a look at each battery and compared them, let's take a look at when we'd recommend each. So when would I go with gel batteries? We'd recommend you go with gel batteries if you're going to run a smaller system, something less than 48 volts. You're not going to be living there full time, such as a batch. You're going to get the most out of your gel batteries if they're full most of the time. Or you want to run DC appliances. You cannot run anything directly off the lithium batteries. They're supposed to interface directly with the hybrid inverters. Or if you're looking for a more affordable option up front. So, when would I go with a lithium system? We recommend lithium when you're looking to run a larger system. Our gel battery option has a limit of only 12 batteries, whereas our lithium batteries can be expanded to many times this. you're aiming to optimize the space and weight of the system, or if you're living on the system full time. The lithium batteries will give you the most bang for your buck over the long term when you're using the system frequently. Hopefully this video answers your questions. If you have more, head over to our website. There's a knowledge base there with plenty of articles. If you can't find what you're looking for there, please get in touch. We're always happy to help.